myself for a moment. Forgive me. I forgot myself for a moment.
What?
Sorry. Sorry. I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to.
Go. There's a basket for Smaragda in the warehouse. She's waiting.
What does it mean to be truly righteous? To never succumb to temptation, or to take a vow of chastity despite constant temptation? Our heroine did not know the answer to this question. And preferred never to dwell on it. If it were up to her, she would have chosen the quiet life of a nun. However, destiny had something different in store for her.
Sorry. Maybe I can help.
You're the last person I need, right? Now? Get lost!
Sorry. For the sake of the prayers of all the... Stesha, do you have something prepared for Smaragda? It's cold today, isn't it? Oh, potatoes. Thank you. Thank you.
The sisters loved Indica. Christian love is known to be patient, merciful, and faithful. However, in a lowly human sense, they didn't love her that much. To be completely honest, they didn't love her at all. Many of them felt nothing. However, was not to blame. Were it not for the voice that was inculcating ideas in her, unforgivable for a Christian, she would have been a virtuous and rather mediocre nun. Indica's biggest dream was for that voice to leave her alone once and for all. Her entire life became a struggle, a painful resistance. No matter how hard she tried, no matter how much she tortured herself, the voice grew louder and more convincing every day.
bring some water.